for land. It's a long journey. God says you need spiritual strength. And when Elijah was strengthened, the Bible says he took him 40 days. But he got to Horeb and had an encounter with God. And there is someone here who needs to have an encounter with God to get the right vision. Because what was the problem of Elijah? When God asked him, what is your problem? Why are you going to? He said, I am running away from these people. They have killed all the prophets. I'm the only person left. So he was in fear. He was afraid. He was running. But to where? As he was on the way, God arrested him and said, you are not running nowhere. You are going back after the 40 days and his encounter with God. God said, go back the same route. Go back to that city. And then there are three persons you are going to anoint. So an encounter changes your vision. This is a period of 40 days. You encounter God and then you turn your back from away from the problem and face that problem and face it out. When Elijah had an encounter with God, God gave him a direct word, what we call Rhema. Say, go back there and do this, and it will work. The same thing that happened when Moses was trying to run away from the Red Sea, he turned to God in prayer, and God said, Moses, what is it you have in your hand? Use it now. There are times when solutions to our problems and challenges lie within us, but we are not focused. We are not in communion with God. We come to church, but we are not connected spiritually. It is not enough to have a wire in this place if it is not connected to the source of power. That computer will not boot. And you have a lot of information in the computer to help you do whatever you want to do. But because the wire is there and there is electricity in the house, but the wire is not connected, or is even connected, but the socket is not put on. It's not turned on. If the socket is not turned on, current is not going to come to that computer, and you will not be able to have access to any information there. It is happening in the spiritual. Elijah needed, despite the fact that this is a man of God who has been calling down fire, at a particular stage in his life, he was afraid of Jezebel because the threat was real. My dear friends, there are times you pass through genuine fear, serious threats. People call you and tell you what is happening at home, and you look at your family and you see the key. Whatever they told you that happened in the spiritual, you already seen it working. And some of us are so afraid that they want to go and beg the devil, or they want to look for a way to combat whatever the devil is doing against them with a diabolic means. Because we do not know what God has given us. Even the prophet Elijah ran away. But he was heading towards God. He was climbing the mountain to go and have an encounter. And as soon as he saw God, you know, he was expecting God in a tumultuous situation. And then came the earthquake. God was not there. And the whirlwind, God was not there. But the still small voice, that kind of voice can be heard during this Lenten season. If only you will set aside some time and wait on the Lord. Sit in the presence of God in prayer. Maybe you are not on duty that very day. Don't see it as a day to sit on the phone and call all the numbers in New Jersey. And you are circulating all the rumors, the latest. Have you heard? And you drop another person. Have you heard? And another one comes from Nigeria. Hey, have you heard? This is Lento. And if you are hearing, you are hearing, you are hearing. The only thing you hear is gossip. Meanwhile, God is whispering something. That still small voice that Elijah heard is whispering something that will prosper your life. And you're not listening. You're waiting for the next call. Or have you heard? And at the end of all those things you hear, nothing is made out of it. I read a post recently on internet. And that post said that in the film that is called Terminator, the actor, who is a Schwarzenegger, spoke 700 words. 700 words alone. And he was paid $15 million. And he was asking people, of all the gossip, that even in one sitting of gossip of about 1 or 2 hours, you speak over 3,000 words, how much are you paid? And it appealed to me. It resonated. This actor spoke only 700 words in a whole movie and was paid $15 million. And we pick up our phone and call someone, and we sit on phone for 3 hours discussing people and discussing situations and events that will never bless our lives, that will either antagonize us before God. And after all that gossip, you only waste the battery of your phone and endanger your ear, because that is radioactive wave that you are putting on your ear. What do you gain? And whenever you are filled with gossip, it is difficult for you to hear the still small voice that speaks from the Most High. And that is what it takes. Elijah moved to Horeb, and it took him 40 days. And after those 40 days, he came back with the grace of God and anointed Elisha, Hazael, and John. And then God said, if anyone escapes this one, he will not escape this one. If he escapes this one, he will not escape this one. Why? Because Elijah was a chameleon. He was no longer afraid of Jezebel. He came back to the city and reclaimed his possession. This season, you shall possess your possession. In the name of Jesus. My dear friends, that journey of Elijah to Horeb is also our journey during this Lenten season. If only we can apply ourselves to what it takes to hear the voice of God. Look at the book of Jonah. It was 40 days. Jonah chapter 3 from verse number 4. Jonah announced to the Ninevites, say, 40 days from now, and Nineveh will be destroyed. Maybe there is something that is about to be destroyed within and around you, even in your life. Let's face the truth. Out of sin, out of your own carelessness, out of something you are taking for granted, that is a lifestyle that the Lord does not want you to engage in. Maybe the devil is planning when to disgrace you. And God is speaking out. Say, I give you 40 days. If only you can use these 40 days, that Nineveh will not be destroyed. It will only take a man or a woman of grace to know that God has given me another opportunity. The Ninevites gathered together and said, let's go into prayers and ask the Lord for his mercy. They went into fasting and prayer. And after 40 days, instead of destruction, they received God's mercy. I don't know what you are battling with. I don't know what your past has been. It doesn't matter how long it is. It is never late to come to God. Yesterday I was preaching on Joel chapter 2 from verse number 12. And I was saying, the Lord say, even now, after all you have done, it is not late. Despite the sentence that is hanging on you, I will destroy Israel. God say, even now, if only you pray and ask for forgiveness, I will forgive you. My dear friends, this is a season of mercy. Don't think your sin is too much. Despite that sin, no matter how long it has stayed, God says, even now. Though the prophet has already spoken to you that 40 days from now, Nineveh will be destroyed. No, you know that something calamitous is about to happen. Even now, God can still show you mercy. He's a God of mercy. It is not late to acquire God's mercy so long as you are alive. It may be late when you die. But now that you are alive, God says, even now, like the Ninevites, no matter the sentence that is on you, I can repeal it. He has the power to do it. Even Jonah was not happy when that sentence was repealed. But God has said so, and Jonah has no option. It doesn't matter what the prophets think about you. It doesn't matter what your husband, what your wife thinks about you. It doesn't matter what people are saying about you. It matters your relationship with God. The other one, Basazereha. I'm sorry, I can't translate that one. The Lord is good.
All the
time. Once you reconcile with God, it doesn't matter what people are saying about you. As at the time, a woman who was branded a harlot by the society came to Jesus. Even Simon that Jesus visited, he said, if this man were to be a man of God, he would know the kind of woman that is touching him. But Jesus had forgiven the woman, and it doesn't matter what you think about it. The disciples came back and they were surprised that he was talking to the Samaritan woman. That one is their own cup of tea. Jesus had forgiven the woman, and the other story is for you. It doesn't matter what people are saying. God says, even now, if only you plead for mercy, I will show you mercy. I don't care what people call you and what they say about you. Make yourself right with me, and it will be well with you.
Amen. 40 days. And so, my dear friends, these 40 days that people spent, the 40 days that Israel spent in the desert, was only to bring them to a promised land. Jesus spent 40 days and 40 nights in prayer. But two things happened. After the 40 days and 40 nights, the devil came and he beat the devil hands down. It was not only that he beat the devil hands down. The Bible says he was hungry though, but he returned with power. Are you getting my point here? He was hungry after the 40 days, yes. But the devil tempted him and didn't overcome him. I don't care the temptation or the attack or whatever the devil is doing about you. But if you use these 40 days well, devil will you lose its power over you in Jesus' name. Yeah. Whatever project the devil has against you, by these 40 days, they are nullified in Jesus' name. Yeah. You will need to apply yourself to this time of grace. And the devil will struggle and fail woefully. The devil will fail woefully in your family. They fail woefully about your children. Fail woefully in your finances. The devil will fail in your academics. I said the devil will fail in your spiritual life. The devil will fail in your health. The devil will fail in every project around you. But above all, not only that you beat the devil in every area, that you will go with power. The Bible says, and Jesus returned with power. And everybody was praising him. I am saying that at the end of this season, you will return with power. You will return with power. And people shall praise you. Because the blessings of God shall so manifest in your life that people will go to Thanksgiving with you. You will have a long procession. People will queue beside you. And they will be dancing to the altar to glorify God because of you. Listen to what the Bible says. Verse 14 of Luke chapter 4. He says, Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news about him spread out throughout the region. He taught in their synagogue and was praised by all. Amen. Amen. I like that summary. He returned and people were telling his testimony. Not just in the village, they say in the region. Are you getting me here? He was the whole of Nigeria, Noria, my sister, that's the whole of region. The whole of New Jersey is little. This is a state. We are talking about the eastern region of the United States. The whole of the region, they heard it. And they praise God because of him. Someone will praise God because of you. Stand on your feet and get ready to pray. My friend, this is a great season. It's a season of grace. And it is for you to ask yourself, what do I intend to achieve? Don't let these 40 days pass by. After these 40 days, what next? What do I expect? Jesus, after the 40 days, came home with power. After the 40 days, he came home with power. And news about him spread throughout the region. He preached and people praised him all the way. I don't know whether you waste these 40 days. Will this be a wasted 40 days of prayer? Wasted 40 days of experience? Look at what the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 1. The Bible says, and that this season of grace may not be wasted. Can someone read it for us? If you read 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 10, Paul says, I am not supposed to be called an apostle, but I am what I am by the grace of God. And he says that this grace has not been ineffectual. It is not ineffective. I utilized the opportunity that was given to me. Though I messed up before, but when I came back, every opportunity of grace that was given to me, I made good use of it. I want someone to read those two scriptures for me. 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 1 and 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 10. Hallelujah. Please make it louder.
But by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace to me was not without effect.
By the grace of God, I am what I am. And this grace is not wasted. It is not without effect. You can look around and you see the product of that grace. My dear friends, Lent is a season of grace. Can we look at you after the Lenten season and see the impact of that grace? Is it possible for us to see the impact of that grace after the 40 days? It is your decision to take. Let's take the second scripture.